Dear students, welcome to the leadership program of Odisha State Open University. Here, today we will be discussing about the difference between manager and leader. Now, the first question comes, whether leader is important in an organization or it is the manager? The answer, yes, both are important. Leader has a different skill set to lead the organization, manager to maintain the organization. Now, what is the difference? We usually consider in organizations, the manager should have leadership quality and in general, leader should have managerial quality. Now, what is the difference? If you go to the difference between these two, you can find out that a manager is an administrator. He administers the rules, regulation, find out the proper implementation of these things inside the organization. Whereas the leader is the innovator. He tries to fix the mission, vision of the organization. In this changing world, while everything is changing, the mission, vision, goal of the organization needs to be changed. Who will try to find out what is the appropriate way to go ahead for the organization? This is the work of the leader. By analyzing the strength of the organization, the weaknesses of the organization, the opportunity available in the outside organization, and the threats coming to the organization, the leader tries to formulate a vision and an appropriate mission for the organizations. Now, leaders in this sense are innovators. They innovate new things, and it is the administrator who carries out that mission vision into rules and regulation and carries out the activities. As you know, a manager has a list of functions starting from planning, organizing, staffing, directing, coordinating, budgeting, reporting. And these functions are always internal to the organizations. Besides these points, a manager maintains the organizations, whereas the leader develops the organization. What do you mean by maintenance work? You might have seen the maintenance work in your house. House is built. It is time to time you need to maintain it. You are not reconstructing or redesigning a new house after building it and staying inside it. That is the maintenance work. And a manager does the same activities inside the organization. He maintains the files, he maintains the structure, he maintains the procedure, and it is the leader who develops these things. Now, the next point we will be discussing about control versus inspire. The manager in his position, he enjoys certain authority. That authority to influence the people, and this authority is given by the organization to the manager. That's why a manager with authority exercises power. And this power can be positive power, can be negative power. Positive power to motivate the people, negative power to compel the people to do the work. So, it is the controlling activities which is important for a manager. Whereas the leader, he inspires. He inspires the people to carry out the mission, the vision, the activities of the organizations. I hope you understood the difference between controlling activities and inspiring activities. The leader tries to communicate with the followers so that they can be inspired and he can build trust among themselves. He can make the things done. And another important point, the difference between manager and leader is, manager is fixing short-term goals, whereas The leader fixes long-term goals. What do you mean by short-term goals? What do you mean by long-term goals? The major difference is with regard to time frame. We cannot say short-term is 1 day, 2 day or 1 week. It is used in relative sense. So you must understand, if it is a long-term vision, long-term work, long-term activities, it is done by the leader who focuses on long-term achievements for success of the organization, whereas the manager focuses on short-term goals, how to achieve in successive manner, and he divides goals into short-term objectives. Now, next important point is manager always questions how and when, whereas leader question what and why. So let's say in an organization there is a set of rules. How to implement, when to implement, who has to carry out the work, all these things are decided by the manager. Whereas the leader questions them, why such rules are there? Instead of can I change the rule, bring out certain new rules? Can I change the process, bring out some new process? Can I change the activities of the person so that people can be more committed, more enthusiastic to work inside the organizations? So this is the role of leader who questions why. Then another important point is leaders are original, whereas managers are copycats. Original, they develop. What is originality? What is innovation? What is important for the organization? That's why they innovate, they originate new ideas to be implemented in the organization. Whereas those ideas are implemented within the organization by a manager. Another important point of difference between manager and leader is that a manager focuses on the shop floor level or the ground level, whereas a leader, the focus is the horizon. What is horizon? The meeting point of the sky and the earth. So a leader, his focus is always on the horizon. He wants to look beyond what other people can see. So for that, you need that kind of skill to analyze what is happening in the world, in the sociological field, economic field, commerce field, and with regard to all other fields. So a leader focuses on the horizon. He goes beyond what other people can see. So normally his skills, his ability makes him leader because of his vision to see what is good for the organization. Whereas a manager mainly focus within the organization and that toward the shop floor level. How the work can be done, how the worker can do work efficiently, effectively, what are the problems occurring there, how to manage those things. The next important thing we will be discussing is with regard to accepting status quo and questioning the status quo. Now the word status quo, it is a legal terminology. And what you understand by status quo? Status quo is the existing scenario or the situation. A manager focuses, as you know, his job is to maintaining the work, controlling the work. His focus is on maintaining the status quo. What is existing in the organization, that should continue. If any deviation, he takes action and he asks people to follow the same rotten path on which everybody is working. But leader questions the status quo. A leader feels if there is a status quo, the growth of organization is hampering. For the growth of the organization, he questions the status quo. He motivates the people to go to a next level. And for that, he prepares them, he decides, designs, of course, in support of the followers or the organization people. Now, the last important point we will be discussing is that it is manager do things right, whereas the leader do right things. What is doing things right? What is doing right things? Do things right. Whatever things are there, it is the manager who will do as per the instruction, as per the manual, as per the policy, as per the objective of the organization, he will do the things in a right manner. But a leader, he questions and he tries to make the things right, and he provides the right path. If there is anything which is hampering the progress of the organization, he questions that. That's why a leader do right things, and to do the right things he follows ethics. As you know, ethics is one of the important part. So a leader always follows ethics, inspires people to carry out the activities. I hope this clarifies the two terminology used very frequently in organization about manager and leader. But before ending, let me tell you, the organization needs both. There has to be people who will think about the progress, who will take the organization to a next level, who will try to find out new vision, new things for the organization. And there should be a set of people who has to maintain and carry out the activities within the organization. Thank you.